So I'm joined here today by Professor Robin Banerjee from the University of Sussex.
Hi, lovely to be here.
Hi, Robin. Welcome to Latest TV.
Thank you.
We're going to be discussing kindness. Earlier this month, we had the World Kindness Day.
That's right, 13th of November.
Yep. And I know that you've been looking into the whole idea, concept of kindness,
yep,
and how that relates to other issues such as mental health in a bit more detail. So did you want to tell us about what you've been up to?
Yeah, absolutely. So my background is in developmental psychology. So I do a lot of work in schools where mental health and well-being are really big issues, quite rightly so. And people have been trying to understand the best ways to support young people who might be at risk of mental health difficulties. But quite often it's framed in quite a negative way. It's sort of like identify the children who have difficulties or are likely to have difficulties and then do something to fix them. And I think it misses out on a really important point, which is like what the context is like. And that took me into the realm of kindness, because actually one of the most important things we can do is to create a kind context where people are supported so that the whole school environment, the whole school community is one which supports kindness. And that got me thinking about kindness everywhere. In the way that I do, I start getting interested in different angles, and I start thinking even about our own workplace at the university, but everywhere really. What are the things that make a place kind, and what are the things which facilitate kindness, that enable people to be more kind, and what are the barriers to kindness as well?
Because in the workplace, of course, sometimes it's a competitive environment if you want to get promoted.
Exactly.
So it's really hard to... It's really contrasting, is it?
Yeah.
So you want to kind of do well,
yeah,
get a higher salary, get a promotion, but also you want to be kind to people that might actually also have the same goals as you.
Exactly. And ironically, I think what we're finding in the research more and more is that by focusing on giving to other people and supporting others, that actually does end up bringing benefits to yourself. Now, I don't mean to say that you should approach kindness as a completely tactical thing, saying that if I do this, then other people are going to respond well to me. But actually, it's one of the things that we find again and again, that the more we orient to other people, to give to a community, to support each other, actually the better it is for absolutely everyone, including yourself.
And so do you think we've become less kind over time? If you read the media every day, well, at least the mainstream media, you would think that we have become less kind, but maybe that's not so true.
It's a really good question. I don't really know the answer to that. My guess is that we're not so good at noticing kindness. Kindness is almost like it's less newsworthy. Mm. As you say, the media is full of stories of the negativity, of the stress, of the problems in life. You only have to look around at all the global issues and you think, my goodness, we're in a dire straits. But actually, there is so much kindness around. And one of the things we often do with children as well as with adults in our research is ask them to notice the kindness when they experience it. And that seems to be really powerful. Mm. And it's very energizing because people feel actually there is so much kindness, so much compassion, so much care in the world around us. We just don't pay enough attention to it. So at University of Sussex at the moment, we're trying to build together an interdisciplinary research group, connecting people from all across the university. So on World Kindness Day earlier this month, we had a symposium which brought together people doing research in psychology, like myself, people doing clinical work, therapy. We had people from international aid, people on counterterrorism, people doing research on social work, people doing work on the business environment. We even had people doing work on kindness towards the environment and animals as well. So I think there was a real interest, and at least I felt it there. I think all of us there experienced that sense of, wow, there's so many people who have these perspectives, different perspectives on kindness, but we can come together and learn from each other. So that's what we're trying to do, and we're excited about where it might go.
Great. And where can people find out more information about the work that the University of Sussex are doing?
Okay, probably the best place would be our Twitter handle, Sussex Kindness. There's information about the World Kindness Day events that took place earlier this month. And we're going to be, it's just a fairly new process for us.
Yeah.
So we're just launching this. So we're going to have a website to accompany that very soon. That's in development at the moment. But there'll certainly be information on the Twitter which people can follow.
And there's a Twitter feed, isn't there?
Yeah,
great.
There is.
Okay, and we can put it up on the screen.
Absolutely, that'd be fantastic.
Great. Professor Banerjee, thank you for coming in today.
It's an absolute pleasure.
Thanks
for having me.